Story time. So a while back, I started doing some nude modeling at a local art school. And I highly recommend it if you want to find out exactly what's wrong with your body. Because a photo shows you what you think is wrong with your body, but a drawing shows you what the world thinks is wrong with your body. Wow, what an interesting body. Did you notice how his nipples point in different directions? I did not. Thanks for that eating disorder. Anyway, last summer, this girl gave me her drawing of me to take home. And I think she was flirting because she drew me unrealistically muscular. But she also drew my meat so small that it looked like a scar. Like, at a glance, I looked like a female bodybuilder. Then I had to take two trains and a bus home carrying a giant drawing of myself naked, which felt really narcissistic. But to everyone else, it just looked like I was a huge fan of transgender Hulk Hogan. But wait, it gets worse. Come back tomorrow to find out what happens next. Story time, part two. After getting fat shamed at the art school, I quit the nude modeling job and decided it was time to get in shape. The next day, I went for a jog, and I knew I was in trouble when this muscle started hurting. Because this is not a jogging muscle. This muscle hurting when you jog is like a football player faking a foul when he was watching the game on TV. Next thing I know, I collapse on the ground and suddenly I'm waterboarding myself with my own sweat and tears. A crowd even started to gather, which really hurt my feelings because it was bigger than most of my comedy audiences. And then this one guy leaned in and had the audacity to heckle me. He said, "Bruh, how far did you run?" And you know you're in bad shape when somebody asks you that and you can just point at exactly where you started. So then he picked me up and carried me to the hospital and actually I'm running out of time for this TikTok, so come back tomorrow and I'll finish the story then. Story time, part three. So where were we? Oh right, I got fat shamed as a nude model and then hospitalized from trying to jog literally 30 steps. Apparently I tore two ligaments in my ankle, so the doctors put me on crutches for the next 6 weeks. And that was by far the most humiliating part of this story. Because no one ever talks about how difficult it is to use crutches. Even something as simple as walking to the bathroom feels like a whole episode of Ninja Warrior. So after only 20 minutes on crutches, I became the world's biggest advocate for disabilities. I called up my landlord and said, "Why is our building not wheelchair accessible? This is disrespectful to our community. We literally will not stand for this." Anyway, long story short, it's been about a year since the accident, and my ankle still isn't completely healed. Getting old sucks.